Dear students, today we are going to talk about electric field lines. We had talked about the concept of electric field in our previous lecture. So let us try to find out what electric field lines are. Suppose we have a small positive test charge Q0. If it is free to move in an electric field, say this is point A, then it moves from point A to point B. Then this curve, which represents the path along which this unit positive test charge is free to move in the electric field. Suppose there is some electric field E acting. So this curve determines the electric field line due to this electric field. Now, at every point, the tangent drawn represents the direction of electric field at that point. It means whatever the point may be, say it is B, if I draw a tangent, it will represent the direction of electric field at that point, which is point B. So if I want to define it, I'll be defining it as an electric field line is the curve along which a small positive charge would tend to move when free to do so in an electric field, and the tangent to which at every point gives the direction of electric field. Now let's talk about some important properties of electric field lines. So, my first line states that electric field lines are continuous curves. There is no break in between the curve. They form a continuous curve. Because this electric field line represents the path of a unit positive charge, if there are breaks in between, it means the charge is vanishing at that point. However, this is not possible. Hence, your electric field lines are continuous curves. So, first point which we have is that our electric field lines are continuous curves. The second point, no two lines of force can cross each other. Suppose I have one electric field line like this and the other electric field line like this due to some electric field E. It would mean that for this curve, the tangent would be like this, and for this curve, the tangent would be like this. So at a similar point, at a common point P, I have two directions of electric field, which is not possible. Hence, no two lines of force can intersect. No two lines of force. To be more correct, no two electric lines of force or electric field lines can intersect. So we have covered two properties. Now let's move on to the third property. They start at positive charge and end at negative charge. What do we mean? They start from positive and end at negative. Suppose I have a plus Q charge here and a minus Q charge here. My electric field line would have direction in this way. It would start from the positive charge and end in the negative direction. Now why so? Why does it flow away from positive charge and towards the negative charge? My dear students, I have already told that it represents the path followed by a unit positive charge. Since positive-positive repel, so it would definitely repel the test charge away from it, and negative and positive would attract, so minus Q would attract it towards it. So the path would be for the plus Q not charge, test charge, it would be away from Q towards minus Q, and hence your electric field lines of force are directed away from Q and towards minus Q. The third point, this was the third point, that they start from positive and end at negative. Now moving on to the fourth point. If my electric field lines are close to each other, it represents a stronger electric field. However, if they are far, it represents a comparatively weaker electric field. So, our fourth point states that the relative closeness of the lines of force indicates the strength of electric field at different points. Let's move on to the fifth point. The electric field lines are always normal to the surface. Suppose I have a plane surface. The electric field line due to a charge plus Q on the surface would be radially outwards perpendicular to the surface. So always remember that the electric field lines are always normal to the surface of a conductor, no matter what is the shape of the conductor. The electric field line E would always be normal to the surface of the conductor. Let's come on to the last property, the sixth property, which states that electric field lines have a tendency to contract lengthwise and expand laterally. Well, I'm reserving this property for the next video. I'll explain this property when I discuss about sketching lines of force for various cases in the next video, and there'll be a case of electric dipole, electric field lines due to electric dipole. I'll be explaining this property in that portion. So I'm reserving this property for now. I hope all the other properties are clear to you and the concept of electric field lines is also clear to you. So let's wait for the next video in which we'll be discussing about sketching lines of force for various cases. Thank you.